is spoken in the Bible, and you are encouraging younger children that are looking at you, that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost, according to 1 Corinthians, for you to be destroying it, you are destroying your future, and you are saying, God, come and fight me. God will not fight you in Jesus' mighty name. Desist from anything that can engage you and God in battle. I've told you before of a man that slapped a pastor and said nothing will happen. And after 10 years, when everything wiped away, and as they were carrying him about, they took him to a church, and the man of God said, there is a pastor you slapped. That is the only pastor that can lay hands on you before this disease will kill you within 48 hours. He eventually died. Don't look for God's trouble. But the one I will be going into today is in Genesis 45. Genesis 45. From verse 7. Anytime you see we that are prophets, that are spiritual man, anytime a spiritual person talk, we know he carry a message. You will see that I am preaching this second day on just a topic the prophet spoke on Sunday. And I can use the next week to keep bringing points out of what you don't use that key when somebody is preaching. I've told you before, it's too sharp. You use the worship key. Genesis 45, verse 7. And God sent me before. And God sent me. God sent me before you to preserve you. For posterity is in the earth, and to save your life. Let me start.
The God we serve is the master planner.
There are some things that happen to you today that God is involved for good. There are some bad things that happen for you, but it's for you to live long. And to learn how to deal with human beings. It was until the armed robber came here and took my jeep and took all our phones, took all the, computer of the church, that I realize I should not be living a careless life again. If God is blessing me, I need to live very careful. My security is very important. Why? A young man just walked in here and he says plumber. Before you know, he started entering every flat, every room here. And a woman came here with some police and said, man of God, you don't know this young guy is a thief, an armed robber. They have seen. They will rob you. I said, man, woman, go. They just robbed me. He brought police. I called my lawyer, go and remove them from police station. My lawyer removed them from police station. I was just naive. I was just innocent. Be an innocent doesn't mean evil cannot catch up with you. Don't be innocent and destroy yourself. So God sends Joseph ahead. All what his brother did to him, to understand leadership. If God is training you and you are rejecting his training, he may abandon you and pick somebody else. Joseph went through all, and God let him know, people from your father's house can betray you. People you don't know from nowhere. His own purpose being around Jesus was to steal money. Because Jesus said, the Bible said, Jesus knew Judas was a thief. He made him a treasurer. That was his mission. That was why he sold him out. Knowing fully well that Jesus will command angels to come down and they will kill and they will have more crowd in their church and there will be more money. His own is all about money. Your failure to understand this, you will not rise. People will waste opportunity in your hands. They will even kill you young. And God sent me before you. How can you say God knew about how your brother sold you? God knew there's something that God used to train us. As a prophet now, you are coming around me, I will first pause and I'll be praying, God, what is this person's agenda? Because I've seen this all. I've seen someone that comes even as a pastor, at the end, he destroys everything in my hand. You may not understand when some pastor will come at the gate and I'll be telling pastor, you want to see prophet? I'll say, tell them I don't know them. They can't see me. You know, I have under go the pain. So something that God is training you now, and we learn train more in pain. Nobody learn easily in plenty. That's why you can never see any leader to be the son of the rich man. He can't lead well. What does he want to teach? So Joseph said, God sent me before you to preserve you. A posterity in the earth. And to save life by a great deliverance. I've said it many times that God told me that VTM is not just common church. VTM is a church to preserve stars. Great people. The last man standing in every family. The hope of every family. That without you, your family is gonna. They are alone forever. Now see somebody like me today. See someone like the king today. Without us, where would our family be now? That there's no father, there's no mother. Where would our family be now? Without us. And that's why God says, send is a prophet. Don't joke with your people. Just like a man of God that came to you and an elderly woman. Say, I like the way you are pastoring. I like the way you are handling things. I don't want God to fight me. I don't want his trouble. But you know that he has sent me ahead of a lot of you. And that's why I always said the pastor, I will not compromise. If you are not doing it well, I will not accept it. Do this work well. I don't want God to fight Because it was what the sons of Eli did that made God to reject Eli. It was not the sin of Eli. So as my son spiritually, as my daughter, I must always stand to correct you. And when I'm preaching like this, please, usher, always go around the compound. There are some children that as soon as I climb the altar, they will go and park themselves at the back there, talking. It's just there. Or maybe what we'll be doing, we'll ask them to be losing Bruno. So any child, dog, eat. Now you need to be inside church. So from next Sunday, we'll be losing Bruno. Lose the dog. There's nothing you are doing in the quarters. So lose the dog for the quarters. Anybody that they went to the quarters, is that you want to go and steal or you want to go and plant something there? So if dog catch you, fine. We have not built this place that a preacher will be preaching and somebody will be at the back here talking. What then do you come to church for? See, I will not pastor a church. After the choir sing finish, you will not see them outside talking. I will pour water on them. Let them try it in. Go, know the kind of a person I am. You can't tell me that you are serving God and you are pressing phone and you are laughing with phone. Let me just catch you. Because if you don't want to serve God, look somewhere else. Don't use your own and God will not curse me. No. So many of these things, God has prepared me now. Because member can allow God to fight you. Your children can allow God. It's all is in the Bible. So if you don't prepare yourself before you are mount to leadership, you just waste your name, waste your life. It was not sin of Saul that made God to be angry with him. It was people. Come and sacrifice. Come and sacrifice. Come and do it. He said, I push myself. I have to force myself because the way they were crying to me. That's why I always tell a lot of people, Baba, pray for us. I say, pray for yourself. Don't push me. No, you can't push me to do what God is not asking me. You can't push me to give you fasting. You can't push me to give you prayer points. You can't push me to tell you what God is not saying. I will rather shut down. Sometimes I will off my phone. Is it not when you get me, you will talk? Is it when you get access to me, you will talk? Why? He sends him. He prepares him. When God is preparing you, it's always hard. He wants you to feel the pains. He wants you to understand. Now I am driving, I'm very careful. Those days you will see me park behind Suya. 9 o'clock in the night. I'll be bus of behind Suya. By Popov. I can't hide now. I'll just be looking like somebody's coming beside me. Why? I am prone to different attack. Yes, I've not gotten money yet to surround myself with mopo, but I have my leg to run, to hide myself. It's not why you see me in bus stop, you fight me. You can't see me in bus stop now. It's in those days you will see me in bus stop. I've learned that. Anyway, I'm going to, I should be very careful. When God sends you to preserve the health and to preserve your people, verse 8 said, so now it was not you that sent me either. This is not what your uncle did to you, it's God. Like I was telling my brother the other day, I said, one of my uncle's son that was in Dubai begged me for money. So I sent 100,000 to him. So my brother in Dubai, I said, what are you going to contribute? He said, we only give 30,000. So he gave 30,000. I said, you try. You try. With all your 24 hours working in Dubai, you try. We that are in Nigeria are even more richer. I don't know what people are looking for about. So I told him, I said, I thank God. I remember 1988. My father died in 1986. I said, this man packed all my father's clothes with his wristwatch, with all his car. I was there, not that somebody told me. They bought everything. He was using my father's wristwatch. That was 1986. He now took me to a farm to go and be farming. By 1998, by 1988, that I gave my life to Christ, I ran away. Before somebody come and kill me in farming. God did not call me to come and farm. He called me as a pastor. So I ran away. That was my last time of sinning. The last time we saw again was when I got married in 1999, 10 years later. He was not apologizing, begging me. And I told his son, all the wear your father were wearing, all my father's car, all his wristwatch, where are they today? Where are they today? I said, I will keep doing good. God sent us to preserve family's name. Because he bears the same name with my father, because it's my father Junior's brother. I will take care of his children. I will take care of you guys. I will not think of what your father did. But I will remember that he's an evil man. So anybody I see an evil character in you, I will deal with you. This man was so bad that my father gave him 3 rooms, married 2 wives for him, gave him a car. I remember when my father was sick and he could not go out to get money in the bank. It's not those days that these days we use ATM. You have to sign a check and go to the bank. He said, go to my brother, ask him to give you some money so I can buy drug. I went to where he was drinking beer with his friend and I gave him the list of the drug my father needed. He shouted at me, go away. And I left. My father could not get the drug until he died. So I've learned that an evil person will always be an evil person. This is why I don't forgive a bad person. When you see a bad person begging you, it's either you cut them or you are about to destroy them. They don't beg you because you have not understood them. They only beg you because you have caught them. So the best you can do is to distance them. That was why I distanced my uncle for years until he died last year. So I told his children, anyone I see the trace of your father in your life, don't let your uncle send you an errand God did not send you. Don't let your friend send you an errand God did not send you. But all my uncle did was to train me to trust in Jesus Christ. That's why I said, A to Z, I'm on live on Facebook now. There's no human being on this earth that can say they are the helper of Joseph, Enoch, Apata. Nobody, no human being. Except God. By giving me a gift of prophecy, I will prophesy to people. Thou seest the Lord. How did you know? Oh, Lord, so bad. Take. Thou seest the Lord. How did you know? God. That's how God of the prophets has helped me all my life. The man that gave the professor that gave me a duplex to get married to my wife in 1999, it was thou seest the Lord. I told him, I said, thou seest the Lord. By Nuluwa Omoguso. Olorun ke se ba 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 ono Allah. Road will be open. And he did it. He said, what do you want? I said, I want to get married. He said, go and write the list of what you needed. And when the man saw that I'm a young man, he said, he wanted to be using me. He said, I will be paying you a salary every month, but you have to be selling drugs on my behalf. I said, me, a preacher, selling drugs for you. Okay. If that's the way God wants my life to be. So I want to open a drug. Don't let me mention the name of the drug company before the drug company come and sue me. So we register. He said that. He said, after having registered, you will not put the bag on your shoulder. You will not be going about. I said, let me go and ask God first. So I went to go ask God. God, professor said I should become drug seller. I should be going to various universities and be selling to professors. God told me, I have not made you a drug seller. I have made you a preacher. Don't sell drugs for him. So I told him, sir, God said I am a preacher, not a drug seller. He said, then I won't give you money again. That was 1999. So 2000. Over 20 years ago. That was the last time we spoke. Don't betray God because of friendship. I have never betrayed this Jesus Christ of Nazareth for any human being on this planet Earth. I said, professor, owe your money. I will keep preaching. If I perish, but I cannot even perish. There is reward in this world. There are many things that I've seen in life that, like, Pastor Adibu said one day, he said, he traveled on the sea, and when the ship, we carry them up and land about seven-story building, and everybody thought they would die. And God told him, go and sleep. Nothing will happen to you. Before you wake up, everything will be okay. And he went to sleep. And when he woke up, everything was okay. He said he was sharing the testimony with some people. And he said, you are a great man of faith. He said, no. I am just privileged to hear from God. And that's my secret. I am just a privileged man that I hear from God. So as Jacob said here, as soon as you are saying anything to me, I'll be asking God, is it true? Is he lying to me? So the professor, I don't know where he is today, but what he did to me, by not being my Alpha and the Omega, what God wanted him to do was to just help me get money and stop there. Not to not be telling me how to live my life. That as a pastor, you can do business. As a pastor, you can go and get a job. As a pastor, you can go and do a driver. I told him, God have not told me that. So now it was not you that sent me either. Like I was telling Apostle Pastor, now he's hearing me say, man of God, when are you coming to Galapagos? I said, I'm not coming again. God just give me a major breakthrough. I'm not, for 1 year, I will not enter plane. For the next 1 year. Yeah, come and carry me here now. Me enter plane. When I just got a breakthrough, I am not entering plane. I'm not entering any plane. Make everybody stay where you are. Don't let human beings send you an error of not coming back. It was not you that sent me either. But God, may your life, may my life always embark on the mission of God in Jesus' mighty name. They will not send you and your children in Jesus' mighty name. He said, and he has made me a father to Pharaoh and Lord of all his house and ruler throughout all the land of Egypt. That is why I am angry with some pastors. When God send you an error, let me define that for you. You become this 14. You'll be a father. Baba, Baba, everybody's calling me Baba now. Both the one that is older than me, those the one that is age of my mother, father, ruler, prophet, Lord. You can't say you are on the errand for God and you are disturbing some family. Please come and pay the church rent. Come and pay the all rent. Come and buy us keyboard. We have never done that here before. The one that sent me an errand. Always, I remember one day. Was it Michael? No, I think Prosper. No, that should be me. I can't remember now. Either Michael or Prosper naming ceremony. I love killing ram during my children's naming ceremony. And I thank God that I stood my ground, said each of my children, I'll be, because I learned that from my late father. Any sporting ram will go, goat will go. So I promised my son, I said, each of my children in the naming ceremony, I'll be killing ram, big ram. So there was this particular, I think it is a Prosper. I think it's Prosper. There was no dime anywhere. There was no copper anywhere. So where I was, somebody now told me of a man at the head when I was in Ibadan that is now a bank manager in Indumota. They gave me his contact. The address of his bank, his phone number. So I called him. I didn't tell him what I'm coming for. So when I landed in the bank around 9 o'clock, I saw he was a big man. I've been suffering. How my wife just gave back, we have not even paid us to be. How I needed money to do naming. This man did not give me 5 naira. As I was leaving Dumota to go back with my Kotuegbe, I heard God saying, see down where we put you. You are a man of God. Don't be only after human being to beg for money. Stay where we put you. We will always send you an assignment. It's when you do your job, people will now give you an offering. Thank you. So I went back to where we were doing fellowship. As I sat down there in Ekololu, Bishop Atilade's house, I just saw some 2 people that walked in. I want to see prophet. I said, are they here? I've been sitting down here since 12 o'clock. I came back from the bank. But they have come for counseling. So the man said, I brought my friend to come and see you. You pray for me last month. God answer my prayer. I just brought my friend. I said, okay. As they sat, this is, as I talk, this is what, because this is what you want. Ah! How did you know? I said, that's what God just told me. You are a really prophet of God. I said, I am now. But why poverty is around me? Even me, I don't know. I said, there's no poverty around you. I said, even I want to do naming tomorrow now. There's no ram. I said, I will buy that. Ah, now I will buy that. They went and bought a very big ram with a bag of rice, with money. They even took me from that place to Ikotuegbe. God now told me, since that year, if I need money, you see me sit down in the church. Like this afternoon, I was looking at my process. How much remained there? They say 45, 4, 5. I said, 4, 5. Now you are going to sit down. Somebody just knocked my door. Maybe he's Baba in the office. I said, I did here. He can't money. I said, he did my joke. He's not here. It's become me. I got a lot on him. There's somebody here. The Lord listened to me. It was an enemy that commissioned you to do what you are doing now. And but you see that you are not successful. Remember that when Pastor came here, he said he was into oil and gas business. And he would track a mine. You know, people that do oil and gas business, they always have white handkerchief that turn to brown handkerchief. And by their shoe, you will know them. Oh, the guy knows, okay, the shoe have gone upstairs because of waka waka. They will trek some miles before they can enter a bus because it's only 50 naira that remain in their pocket. They know how to drink pure water and eat granules. So when he told me I'm doing oil and gas, I said, for many years now, I think he mentioned about 7 years. Sorry, how many amounts have you making this? He said, there's a cargo on the... Oh, I said, somebody's this cargo on the water. Stop it. He brought some guys here. He said, they know Obasanjo. Obasanjo is their friend. Those are the people that were collecting money from me when his father was alive, 500,000, 1 million. There's a cargo. The jet of the cargo just spoiled. If we can raise us 2 million now to repair the jet, when the cargo landed, now we'll make money. He will go and be packing his late father money, we'll go and be giving them. The one the old man didn't give him, he will go and steal it. Cargo, they never repaired, finished for the past 20 years now. Until I told him, solve this thing. Don't let your innocent wife suffer. Yes, that is your life. There are some people that are doing a business, that are doing a job, that is an enemy that engaged them. Oh, Gbesele Lowo. Koma ba roju, koma raye. So you will not be able to focus on your original agenda. That's why I told you last Tuesday in our people let's pray. Always pray for yourself. As you pray, God will reveal to you your visions or your dreams. Or through preaching like this. Do you see the testimony of that woman on Sunday? That every time that her son wants to clock the birthday, there will be an attack. But he went to a pastor, only that they want to use another avenue to attack the innocent boy. If he had said, I don't have time to come to a prophetic church. Leave me in my Ibadan. Such a gift that God gave to me, to her. The way that the enemy just unnecessarily give you a job just to make sure you are distracted from the original plan of God. Such people this evening, you are delivered in Jesus' mighty name. It was not you that sent me, it was God. And let me say this, any error human being send you, you will regret it. Make it bold. Always run an errand for God. Go and ask Abraham, the one he ran for Sarah, go and sleep with my maid. We are still suffering it for tomorrow. When we came to this area in 2007, my wife said, I know you are a good pastor. This one you are not doing anything. Go and start the church. I said, go and call your Baba now. You don't get Baba. Go and wake him in the grave. Make him start church. Now you call me. Now you be my God. Let God send me to go and pastor. Not you go. Send me to go and start church. Since that day, she shut up her mouth. There are many people that they are running ministry because their friend telling them that you can be a good pastor. They will suffer. That was why when Sarah now told him again, send this woman and her son away, he went back to God. Don't carry an errand for a human being. He said, it was not you. So now, he said, it was not you that sent me here. So now, verse 8. It was not you that sent me either, but God. Oh, Jesus Christ. When we were building this place, God told me, make it high and give it, put a gallery. One of the evil pastors that we had here before. Baba, make it low. That's why we could not achieve the gallery tomorrow. Anytime human being talk to you, go back to God. hear the final say from God. Don't let human beings send you an error. Many marriages are destroyed today because of women listening to their colleagues, their friends in the offices. If it's me, I will not give for my husband. No. You, you didn't move for that one. You will not do their not be me. And at the end of the day, if you are thrown out of that marriage, the same friend will not be mocking you. As a father, as a husband, as a pastor, as a prophet, anytime women being talk to me, I go back to God. Most of the time, we say, don't mind them all. And to my run is don't mind them. Follow your heart. Follow your heart. When I was personally with my friend, the prophet, I was just reading my Bible one day. He called me and said, can we go to Abuja tomorrow? And God says to me, if you follow him to Abuja, you will not come back. I said, sir, you know, say, I don't like plane. Today, my sweet make I don't enter plane. He dropped the phone. When he called me back, I was hearing some people tell him like this. Tell him you should go and book, God is good. I told him, I said, I don't come Abuja. As soon as he dropped, God told me, they had planned to kill you. If you have been back on that journey. This CAC man that worked with Abiana before, you know, he came from Ibadan to Lagos to come and do a pastor's meeting, and they poisoned him. He died. Don't embark on the errand of human beings. So now it was not you that sent me either. Go! Jesus Christ. Whenever you see me do anything, I am not doing it to please anybody, to make anybody happy, but because of God. Okay, I had only 500,000 in my account. I transferred 400,000 to Onaga. Where's Onaga in church today? Which means now even more richer than me. I checked my balance now. It has even dropped to 75,000. Which means more richer than me. But you know why I'm not regretting it? God said, give him for his father's burial. If it was me that gave him, I would have been angry. I would have cut my hair. Oh, him go on. You know the hair who 400,000 in this time. But because it's God, he has a way of paying me back. That is my consolation. Anything you are doing to please human being, kokimba irorunde, it won't please you at the end of the day. I will not do any program to make anybody happy, to make this church big. No, I will do program because God asked me to do it. I will not. So now it was not you that sent me either. Oh God. One of the mistakes of my late father was that he liked pleasing people. And I told myself I would learn one thing. I would rather like pleasing God. Is any assignment God asked me to do, I would do on behalf of God. So God will be able to defend me to my old age. See, human being who gave rice and beans today, the next day, for 1 year. The one day you are tired, you are sleeping, they will go and discuss about you outside. That's why Joseph said, I am not here for your mission. I am not carrying out your agenda. I am not. I came from God's mission. And that's the reason why you're on this earth. He created you to glorify His name. He created you first for His assignment. He created me first for His assignment. At the level I am now, people will think that maybe I've built a house in my village. I've not even built a room. I've not even built a room. Things of God first. Things of God first. People of God first. The Bible says because the midwife served God, He built them a house. It's God that built them a house. I've seen pastors that people will contribute money, they will go and be used to buy land and be building. No. You must understand the primary reason that you are here is for God. Let somebody say amen. Because when you are working for God, He will make you a father. He said, if the reward of them that diligently seek Him, God. He told me some years ago when I gave my life to Christ, and I'll be asking God, why are these pastors? Why are these people? Because I ate wanting poverty. For my shoe to bend at 40, at 50. For my shirt to tear. For my trouser. God knows I ate it from the beginning. But if you are young, you can be wearing all that. They will think you are just like you wear, you cut your clothes now. You are doing boys. But if me go cut my clothes, they will know I've done the crazy. It's like the owner has 48 now. I will not be zaggy. I will not be, they will know say, Igbo, Ozimugbo, you don't shack cocaine. Or Kodi, you don't go, this mama don't go green Kodi. There's something you do when you are young. But when you are old, we expect honorably look from you. A father look from you. You should represent, because you are now representing God, your family, and your children. So God told me, majority of these pastors started pastoring because of their belly, not because I called them. If you serve me well, I will not let you be poor in your old age. On Monday, the pastor was telling me, he said, Baba, all my joints. I said, there is nothing, there is not them, no, don't be afraid. Say, this one we got, don't give you breakthrough. You want to become a king, maybe not enemy, not be enemy. Now the dance, come, you know. Everybody, if you ask pastor, the name of pastor before in this church, now komole, komole, komole. Either the drum sweet or the song sweet or not, you don't komole. Praise, I want you not sweet, you don't komole. So when he was komole on Sunday, I said, this man, you are comparing yourself with me. So on Monday, I said, all my joints, Baba, Boboroku, me, Romi, money, Ipuni, no be juju. Oh, they don't call. Oh, they jini. Oh, they don't call. Nobody they do you. Nobody they do you. So next time when you are dancing, you dance when you're just. Mama, she buy ma. Mama, ready. Ma, for boy, she didn't see. Use wisdom. Don't be komole like that again. Change your name. Let them call you a redeemer. Don't they come on again? Because now your joint go tell you on the bed. He they pay me. Oh, they don't come now. Either you like it or not. Your joint will tell you. That's why I always say my grandma. Whenever I see us coming on the other, she too, pity yourself, oh. Pity yourself, oh. And then this mother, you see her shaking. I told you before, see, go and sit down. Go and sit down. Now, old age. So I always fear that shame in old age, and none of us will see it in Jesus Christ. No. We will not see shame. We will not see poverty. We will not see sickness in Jesus' mighty name. We will not see it. And I thank God today. Like, I was telling someone today, I said, at 48, when I was doing my 45th birthday, I saw somebody crying in the church. And I said, why are you crying? After the service, why? Ah, he said, his senior brother is 45 like me, but not married. No child. Nothing to show for it. See, he saw me marking 45 years, 3 years ago. He saw my wife. He saw my children. And he saw what God, he says, there are some people that have used a wasted life. You will not live a wasted life in Jesus' mighty name. But if you go and run your own errand of human being, they will just waste your life. I've used my life to serve my brother. Who sent you? See the way they abandon me now, human being? That's why I'm telling my children, I told my wife today, I am not Jesus Christ. I will not go die for you. No. If you see the bill they brought to me for convention, now yet I shall, oh, you all the way. Now I begin to counsel. Now she see frown. Now me too, I frown. I said, even the one where I promised I would give, I don't even get that. I don't get. I counsel small, you the friend. By tomorrow, I go even counsel more. Because even the money where I promised you, you see that the woman came. He didn't give me any money. Ah! Every money where all of us expect. The woman don't drop any money. So, the counsel must continue. So, as she frowned, me too, I frown. No, be so. Don't go and get. I have used my life to serve these children. If you die, just die for. You will see some people, they will go and put children in the school that will not give them change in their pocket to take care of themselves. No. I have used my life to serve my family. I have not served anybody. I am only serving God. Whatever I am doing it according to my level. I am not stressing myself. I am not. See Green Spring beside me here. You think I don't know how to put my children in Green Spring? But Green Spring, you will soon become Yellow Spring. If he's waiting for me. Don't, because people, you are killing yourself. Are you hearing me? They will tell you tomorrow who sends you. If you don't be saying that God asked me to fast, now all of us are going to fast together. If I do 2 days, you go do 3 days. If I do 1 day, you go do 4 days. Baba, the first one, just thank Jesus. Just thank him that he gave me grace. And I'm hearing him. Now, so one pastor go fast. He died. When he was sick, all his members left him. I am advising you, pastor, take care of yourself. You cannot be Jesus Christ. Time you need to rest. Time you need to eat, don't be answering call. Put the phone down. Anybody that coming by 6 o'clock that I'm breaking, you are devil. Why are you not coming 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock? Why 6 when I'm breaking? The only person that can come in by 6 that I will pick is my lawyer. When my lawyer come here, he say, I just eat the first soup, the second one. I say, lawyer, see you. I want to serve any. No. I just get some information I said I'll give you. Later, let's talk later, Jerry. But Papa, pray for me. 6 o'clock. What about the prayer? Why don't we pray since 7 o'clock? 7 a.m. Don't say that I'm doing the work of God. No. Do the work of God at the appropriate time and take care of your health. If you die for somebody, they will look for another pastor. They will look for another prophet. Even the wife will look for another husband. So what? Amen. Even God can satisfy a woman. He gives them ear, they will cut it, they will put wig. Eyelashes, they will use blade. Remember, put what in. Eyebrow. Who does that? You will see some women, they have fine lips. They go put red lips. God gives someone of them fine name. They will go put in Japan name. If they go to several rounds, you just die. I want to satisfy my wife. Just do one round. Deal what I go sleep. If you want to say, leave me alone. Let me satisfy her. So nobody will touch her. Nobody will touch her. Use Bible, bang her. Hey, you want to say, okay. Rest. You don't rest. If they use you finish, you can't satisfy a woman. You see, first day, if you do 4 rounds, you might just need to rest for 1 hour. As soon as you rest, you need another 4 rounds. Stop at that. If he kill you, he will kill you. Miguel, Baba, I miss you. I miss you too. I miss you too. Baba, you okay? I'm okay. Baba, I'm hungry. Miss you, I'm hungry. I'm fasting. Don't be running around for human being. No. Are you hearing me? Be wise. Run your errand for God. I don't hear you. Anytime my children say, "Daddy, I need you," I say, "You don't need this. You need your school fees. The only one I'm owing you is your school fees. Don't come give me unnecessary hypertension. Your school fees, that's what you need. And food in the house. Finish. Unnecessary toy. You will see some father, hypertension they put on that man's head, all the toy. What they call the auditor now? Spider-Man, claws, Spider-Man, pines, Spider-Man, goggle, iPad, goggle. My children can't try that with me. I did not buy them any of those things. The only thing I owe you is your school fees, and there's food in your house, and clothes. Even if it's a tokumbo, I get bend down and big, as long as you're wearing clothes. Amen. Amen. I don't go down for anybody. Me? And I'll not be Jesus Christ. It will be counterfeit Jesus Christ. Counterfeit, fake war. So why die for anybody? Why? Live your life to glorify God and fulfill the assignment He sent you. He will make you a father. But when you are running an assignment of human being, they will useless you. You will see some men, they don't bend. You will not say you never eat well. You go to three like a fancy. You will just a black. You don't know the way I'm black before. Who knows I feel fresh like this? Me where they use wisdom. You say because you see fresh fish, just swallow them. You will just go to let. Sometimes I say fresh fish, stay. Let me, the one way I don't do, let me recover myself. They say one to recover now, 24, 48 hours. Let me recover first. Let me do a fresh skin. You don't see fresh skin now. Wisdom. Every time, download. All your cheeks, Eric, what do you want to do? What the bendy? What the lawyer? They don't use you, tired. And the same person will be abusing you. Now, so your mate, they look. See the way you look. You don't go see your mate outside. You don't see Paul Edoche. They will not be comparing you with Arthur in the TV. Not be your mate with that. Not be me. Not be for this Nigeria. You go use me, finish. You go see the abuse me. Wisdom is profitable for everything, for direction. Don't run errand for human being. You don't see the way I ran away on Sunday? After I don't sing, I don't dance for you. See people line up. Make I see the letter. Before they go kill me, I just run away. I say some of the prophets, which means the pastor. Why do you? I just run away. Good men of God have died like that. You will not give yourself a rest. You just finished revival. Somebody is calling you on the phone. The time you want to break, you are doing counseling, you are doing prayer. You will just collapse. B. Now you go here. As I'm fasting, I know I should not be doing too much of talking. So why would I have several invitations to come and preach? I always turn them down. I say, after the fasting for 10 years, then I can be traveling about. But now, I can't risk my life. Why? There are thousands of good preachers. There are prophets. Don't remove me from the line yet. Anybody, human being, send an error, you can never be a father. You can never become Lord. They will waste you. So next time you see pastor complaining, human being, Lord, it's human being that sent him or her. We that God sent, we are not father, we are not Lord to Pharaoh. So learn from us. Learn from us. Verse 9. Haste ye and go up to my father and say unto him, thus say thy son Joseph, haste ye and go up. There is still space upstairs. Are you hearing me? It's not only Dangote or the Tola and all of them. There is still space. He said, haste ye and go up. You will go up in Jesus' mighty name. If you are thinking you have missed opportunity, your children will go up in Jesus' mighty name. I have never traveled international before, but today my son has traveled. Don't be so. Who is there? Is it not me? Don't be my name there for the passport. Apata, don't be me. If they ask him, you are Apata of where? Apata of Kogi State. Who is your father? Joseph Enoch Apata. Now meet there, dear. Say, S.E., go up. You will go up in Jesus' name. Say, I will go up in Jesus' name. My children will go up in Jesus' name. Shout the prophetic amen. Don't be afraid, there are still space upstairs for each one of us. So he told them, go up to my father and say unto him, thus says the son Joseph, God has made me Lord of all Egypt. Come down unto me, tarry not. Come down. I pray for every one of us above 40 who will not come down again. I say, will not come down again. I say, will not come down again. See, anything you are doing, as soon as you are 40, make sure you don't come down. Are you hearing me? If you have been driving car from 15 years, 18 years, 20 years, 30 years, at 40, if anything happens, you will not recover again. So I prophesy, none of us shall go down. 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 Lastly, in verse 13, and ye shall tell my father of all my glory in Egypt, and of all that ye have seen, and ye shall ask and bring down my father hither. And ye shall tell my father of all my glory in Egypt. There's somebody here. Your father's house will hear your testimony. I say your father's house will hear your testimony. I say your father's house will hear your testimony. I say your father's house will hear your testimony. I say your father's house will hear your testimony. I see your father's house will hear your testimony. I see your father's house will hear your testimony. Your father's house will hear your testimony. Your father's house will hear your testimony. Male Kotohia. And you shall tell my father of all my glory of Egypt and of all ye have seen. And of all ye have seen. They want to see the goodness of God upon your life. They will see it in Jesus' name. I said they will see it in Jesus' name. I said they will see it in Jesus' name. I said they will see it in Jesus' name. I said they will see it in Jesus' name. I said they will see it in Jesus' name. I said they will see it in Jesus' name. I said they will see it in Jesus' name. Of my glory and of all you have seen. That Christmas light that show Baba, I see it on top of some of you, your head. This your light will shine. I said this your light will shine. This your glory will shine. It will keep shining. Man will see. Nation will see. The world will talk about it.